गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, दिस इज क्लास 12th, सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री, चैप्टर नंबर 13, अमीन्स, लेक्चर नंबर 4. इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग केमिकल रिएक्शंस ऑफ अमीन्स. इन केमिकल रिएक्शंस एसाइलेशन, कार्बाइलामिन रिएक्शन, रिएक्शन विद नाइट्रस एसिड एंड रिएक्शन विद अराइल सल्फोनाइल क्लोराइड एंड इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन विल बी डिस्कस्ड. एट द एंड आई विल डिस्कस homework solution of lecture number 3. In the previous lecture we were discussing on the basicity of amines. Now next chemical reaction is acylation. Aliphatic and aromatic primary and secondary amines react with acid chlorides, anhydrides and esters by nucleophilic substitution reaction, and this is known as acylation. Now here you can consider that in this reaction, the replacement of hydrogen atom of NH2 by acyl group, and the product obtained by acylation reaction are known as amides. This acylation reaction is carried out in presence of a base stronger than amine, like pyridine, which removes HCl so formed and shifts the equilibrium to the right hand side. So here is the reaction of ethaneamine with acid chloride in presence of base like pyridine. So here, due to the presence of lone pair or nitrogen atom, this attacks on this carbonyl carbon, and here this pi bond is shifted on oxygen. So here this species is formed. Now what will happen? This negative charge will again shift in between this carbon and oxygen, and from here the Cl is removed. And to remove this positive charge present on nitrogen, this hydrogen-nitrogen bond is broken, and the bond pair of electron of nitrogen-hydrogen bond shifted on this nitrogen, and here we are getting N-ethyl ethanamide. So this is acylation reaction. Reaction of amines with acid chloride in presence of base like pyridine, here amide will form. Next is reaction of secondary amine with acid chloride in presence of base. Again the same mechanism will take place. First this nitrogen will attack on this carbon, and after that the Cl will be removed, and the positive charge of the nitrogen is removed by breaking this hydrogen-nitrogen bond, and here this product, that is N,N-diethyl ethanamide, is formed. So this is the reaction of secondary amine with acid chlorides. Now third is reaction of benzene amine, that is primary aromatic amine, with ethanoic anhydride. So here first step is the lone pair of nitrogen attack on this carbon, and this will be shifted on, this bond is shifted on this oxygen. Now in the next step, this will be shifted back to this carbon, or you can see that this negative charge will be shifted in between carbon and oxygen, and from here this bond will break, and the product is N-phenyl ethanamide or acetanilide. So same mechanism will take place with primary amine, with secondary amine and with aromatic amine. Next reaction is name reaction, benzoylation reaction. Amines also react with benzoyl chloride. C6H5COCl is the formula for benzoyl chloride. So reaction of amine with benzoyl chloride results in the formation of N-methyl benzamide, and this reaction is known as benzoylation reaction. Next reaction is carbylamine reaction. Aliphatic and aromatic primary amines on heating with chloroform and ethanolic potassium hydroxide form isocyanides or carbylamines, which are foul smelling substances. Secondary and tertiary amines do not show this reaction, and this reaction is known as carbylamine reaction or isocyanide test, and is used as a test for primary amines. So here is the reaction. रिएक्शन ऑफ प्राइमरी अमीन विद CHCl3 दैट इज क्लोरोफॉर्म इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ इथेनोलिक पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. ऑन हीटिंग इट विल फॉर्म आइसोसाइनाइड विच आर फाउल स्मेलिंग सब्सटेंसेस एंड KCl प्लस वाटर. सो दिस रिएक्शन इज यूज टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन प्राइमरी अमीन्स फ्रॉम सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शरी. सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शरी अमीन्स डू नॉट शो दिस रिएक्शन वेयर एज प्राइमरी एरोमेटिक एंड एज वेल एज एलिफेटिक अमीन्स बोथ गिव्स दिस रिएक्शन. नेक्स्ट इज रिएक्शन विद नाइट्रस एसिड. थ्री क्लासेस ऑफ अमीन्स रिएक्ट डिफरेंटली विद नाइट्रस एसिड. सो फर्स्ट इज प्राइमरी एलिफेटिक अमीन्स. रिएक्शन ऑफ प्राइमरी एलिफेटिक अमीन विद HNO2 रिजल्ट्स इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस डाइएजोनियम सॉल्ट दैट इज Rn2 पॉजिटिव Cl नेगेटिव. दिस इज नोन एज डाइएजोनियम सॉल्ट. इन केस ऑफ प्राइमरी अमीन्स एलिफेटिक अमीन्स दिस डाइएजोनियम सॉल्ट इज अनस्टेबल एंड इट विल गिव एल्कोहल प्लस हेयर N2 गैस इज रिलीज्ड. हाउएवर इफ वी ट्रीट प्राइमरी एरोमेटिक अमीन्स विद HNO2 हेयर इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ NaNO2 प्लस HCl दिस HNO2 इज फॉर्म्ड. सो रिएक्शन ऑफ प्राइमरी एरोमेटिक अमीन विद HNO2 रिजल्ट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बेंजीन डायजोनियम क्लोराइड. नाउ दिस डायजोनियम सॉल्ट इज स्टेबल इन बिटवीन 273 टू 278 केल्विन टेम्परेचर एंड वेन द टेम्परेचर इज अबाउट 278 केल्विन दिस डायजोनियम सॉल्ट डिकम्पोजेस एंड इट कन्वर्ट टू फिनोल प्लस N2 एंड HCl. सो दिस रिएक्शन इज यूज एज अ टेस्ट फॉर एलिफेटिक अमीन्स एलिफेटिक प्राइमरी अमीन्स बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ प्राइमरी एलिफेटिक अमीन्स N2 गैस इज रिलीज्ड. दिस डायजोनियम सॉल्ट इज अनस्टेबल एंड देयर फॉर इट डिकम्पोजेस टू एल्कोहल एंड हेयर N2 गैस इज रिलीज्ड. हाउएवर इन केस ऑफ प्राइमरी एरोमेटिक अमीन्स दिस बेंजीन डायजोनियम क्लोराइड इज स्टेबल. Only it will decompose if the temperature is greater than 278 Kelvin. So this is the reaction of nitrous acid with primary aliphatic amine and primary aromatic amine. Now next is reaction of nitrous acid with secondary amine. So here in case of secondary aliphatic amine, N-nitroso-diethylamine or yellow oil. So this is the product of secondary amine with nitrous acid. Similar reaction will take place with aromatic secondary amine. Now, if we treat this yellow oil with phenol and a few amount of concentrated H2SO4, this yellow oil is treated with few crystals of phenol with concentrated H2SO4. Here, this yellow oil converts to green solution, and treatment of this green solution with aqueous NaOH results in the formation of deep blue solution. When we dilute this deep blue solution, it changes to red solution, and this reaction is called Lieberman nitroso reaction and is used as a test for secondary amines. So these are the reactions of secondary amines with nitrous acid. This is secondary amine, aliphatic secondary amine, this is aromatic secondary amine. So in case of secondary amines, N-nitroso diethyl amine or N-nitroso dialkyl amine will form. Third is reaction of nitrous acid with tertiary amines. So here in case of tertiary amines, reaction of aliphatic tertiary amine with HNO2 results in the formation of water soluble compound. And with aromatic amines, here this green colored compound is formed. So these are the reactions of primary, secondary and tertiary amine with nitrous acid. Next is reaction with aryl sulfonyl chloride. Benzene sulfonyl chloride, that is C6H5SO2Cl, which is also known as Hinzberg reagent. So reaction of benzene sulfonyl chloride with primary amine, that is RnH2. So it results in the formation of N-ethyl benzene sulfonamide, and this N-ethyl benzene sulfonamide is, when dissolved in alkali, it is soluble in alkali. The reason is this hydrogen attached to this nitrogen is acidic, ड्यू टू स्ट्रांग इलेक्ट्रॉन विड्रॉइंग नेचर ऑफ दिस सल्फोनाइल ग्रुप. सो ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द सल्फोनाइल ग्रुप दिस हाइड्रोजन इज एसिडिक एंड देयरफॉर व्हेन वी डिसॉल्व दिस एन इथाइल बेंजीन सल्फोनामाइड इन एल्कली दिस कंपाउंड इज सॉल्युबल इन एल्कली. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज इफ वी ट्रीट सेकेंडरी अमीन विद बेंजीन सल्फोनाइल क्लोराइड. सो हियर दिस कंपाउंड इज फॉर्म्ड एंड वेन वी डिजोल्व दिस कंपाउंड इन एल्कली दिस कंपाउंड इज नॉट सोल्यूबल इन एल्कली. नाउ हियर इन सेकेंडरी अमीन देयर इज नो हाइड्रोजन विच इज एसिडिक, देयर फोर दिस रिएक्शन इज नॉट पॉसिबल. हाउ एवर इफ यू ट्रीट टर्शरी अमीन विद बेंजीन सल्फोनाइल क्लोराइड सो देयर इज नो रिएक्शन. हियर इन केस ऑफ टर्शरी अमीन देयर इज नो हाइड्रोजन सो देयर फोर रिमूवल ऑफ एच सी एल इज नॉट पॉसिबल. Or you can see that reaction of benzene sulfonyl chloride with this amine is not possible. And therefore, there is no reaction of benzene sulfonyl chloride with tertiary amines. So, this is the reaction of benzene sulfonyl chloride with primary amine, with secondary amine, and with tertiary amines. So, this Hinzberg test is used for the distinguish of primary, secondary, and tertiary amines. Now, next is electrophilic substitution reaction. Now, as we know that NH2 group attached to benzene ring, this NH2 group contain lone pair of electron and this is highly activating group. So, this aniline is highly reactive towards electrophilic substitution reaction. So, first is bromination reaction. If we treat aniline with Br2, that is aqueous Br2, so here due to high reactivity of this aniline, here we are getting 2,4,6 tribromo aniline and along with this product HBr is formed. Because of the high reactivity of this aniline, due to highly activating nature of this NH2 group, it will activate benzene ring towards electrophilic substitution reaction and this group is highly activating, therefore we are getting tri-substituted product. But if we want to convert this aniline to ortho or you can say para bromo aniline, then how will we convert aniline to ortho bromo aniline or para bromo aniline? So in that case we have to control the activity of this NH2 group, or we can say that if the activity of this NH2 group decreases, then we will get ortho and para product. So, the activity of NH2 can be controlled by the reaction of aniline with acetic anhydride in presence of base. So, what will happen? The lone pair of electron present on nitrogen, it will attack on this carbon and here this acetanilide is formed. Now, if we treat this acetanilide in Br2 in ethanoic acid, so here we will get para-bromo-acetanilide. And the hydrolysis in basic or acidic medium again converts this NHCOCH3 group to NH2 and here we are getting 4-bromo aniline. So this is how we can control the activity of NH2 by converting it to a group which is less activating than this NH2. Now why this NHCOCH3 is less activating than NH2? Here in case of NHCOCH3, the lone pair of nitrogen is involved in resonance with this carbonyl group and therefore the activity of this group decreases and here we are getting para product. So if we want to convert aniline to para substituted product, so first we will treat this with anhydride in presence of pyridine. This converts to acetanilide, which is a less activating group than this NH2. Now after that treatment of this acetanilide with Br2 in ethanoic acid, it gives para substituted product and the hydrolysis of this product in presence of basic or acidic medium again converts this NHCOCH3 group to NH2. So this is how we can convert aniline to 4-bromo aniline. So here the reason is written, lone pair of nitrogen लोन पेयर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इज लेस अवेलेबल फॉर डोनेशन टू बेंजीन रिंग बाय रेजोनेंस ड्यू टू द फॉलोइंग रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स. देयरफॉर एक्टिवेटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ NH2CH3 ग्रुप इज लेस देन दैट ऑफ अमीनो ग्रुप. नाउ हियर द लोन पेयर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इज इन्वॉल्व इन द रेजोनेंस विद दिस कार्बोनिल ग्रुप एंड देयरफॉर these lone pair are less available for donation to benzene ring by resonance and hence activity of this NHCOCH3 group is less than that of amino group. Second is nitration reaction. If we do the nitration of aniline in presence of HNO3H2SO4 at 288 Kelvin temperature, so here we are getting three products, para, meta and your ortho product. Now why in this case meta product is formed? Now what will happen in acidic medium, this NH2 group, it will accept proton and it will form anilinium ion. Now this NH3 positive is a meta directing group because here positive charge is on nitrogen and therefore this group is not activating group. It is a deactivating group. So whenever benzene ring is attached with deactivating group, meta product is formed. That is why on doing nitration in acidic medium, this NH2, it will accept proton and form anilinium ion. And because of the formation of anilinium ion, here we are getting meta product. So when we do the nitration of aniline, here three products are formed, para, meta and ortho. So if we want to convert aniline to 4-nitroaniline, then again, first of all, we will deactivate this group or we will decrease the activity of this group. Again, this aniline is treated with CH3COOCOCH, that is with anhydride in presence of pyridine. Here, acetanilide is formed. Now, if we do the nitration, this group is less activating as compared to NH2. So, it will substitute at para position, that is electrophilic substitution takes place at para position. And when we do the hydrolysis in presence of base or H positive, so again this NHCOCH3 converts to NH2, that is para-nitroaniline. Next is sulfonation reaction. Now aniline on treatment with H2SO4, so here anilinium hydrogen sulfate is formed, which on treating in between temperature range 453 to 473 Kelvin, so here the sulfonylic acid is formed, and in this sulfonylic acid proton transfer takes place and here we are getting zwitter ion. So this is the reaction of aniline with H2SO4. Next is aniline does not undergo Friedel-Crafts reactions, that is alkylation and acetylation, due to salt formation with aluminium chloride. Now in Friedel-Crafts reaction, Lewis acid, that is anhydrous AlCl3, is used. This AlCl3 is Lewis acid and now this aniline contains lone pair of electron. So here this complex is formed, this salt is formed, the lone pair of electron present on nitrogen attack on this aluminium and here the salt formation takes place. Now due to the presence of positive charge on nitrogen atom in the salt, the group NH2 positive AlCl3 negative acts as strong electron withdrawing and therefore it reduces the electron density on benzene ring and hence Friedel-Crafts reactions are not possible in aniline. So this Lewis acid, it will accept the electron, the lone pair of electron present on the nitrogen in aniline and here the salt formation takes place. Due to the presence of this positive charge, this will act as strong electron withdrawing and therefore it reduces the electron density on benzene ring and hence Friedel-Crafts reactions are not possible in case of aniline. So after doing this, you can solve NCERT in text question number 13.4 to 13.8 and NCERT exercise question number 2, 3, 6 and 7. Now, I am discussing homework solution of lecture number 3. Question number 13.4, arrange the following. First is in decreasing order of pKb value. So as we know the relation PKB equals to minus log of KB. Larger the value of PKB, weaker will be the base. Now here ethylamine, N-methyl, benzenamine, NN-diethylamine, and here it is aniline. Four amines are given. Now, larger the value of KB, weaker will be the base. So, in these amines, the weakest base is C6H5NH2. So, this amine is having the largest PKB value. After that, C6H5NH3, these two are aromatic amines. Aromatic amines are weaker bases as compared to aliphatic amines. And in aromatic amines, this nitrogen is having two hydrogen. And here one is hydrogen and one is methyl group. So it will donate some electron density to nitrogen. And therefore, the basic strength of N-methyl benzene amine is more as compared to aniline. So this is the decreasing order of PKB values for these amines. Next part is, second part, in increasing order of basic strength. So this is primary aromatic amine, this is tertiary amine, secondary amine, and this is primary amine. So the basicity order is secondary amine is the strongest base, then primary amine, and in aromatic amines C6H5NH2 is weaker base as compared to C6H5NCH3CH3, because here two methyl groups are present, they will donate some electron density due to plus I effect, and therefore the basic strength of this amine is more as compared to this. Third is, in increasing order of basic strength, aniline, 4 nitroaniline and 4 methyl aniline. Now here NO2 group is electron withdrawing group, so it will withdraw electron density from benzene ring, and the lone pair of electron on nitrogen is less available for the donation, whereas if we compare the basicity of these two compounds. So here CH3 group is attached para position. Now CH3 is electron donating group. Due to plus I effect, it will donate electron density to benzene ring, and therefore the nitrogen, the lone pair on nitrogen is available for donation. And here in aniline there is no group. So the basic strength is, whenever electron donating group attaches to aniline, basic strength increases, and whenever electron withdrawing group is attached to benzene ring, basic strength decreases. So here second is least basic, then first, and third is most basic. Next is C6H5NH2, C6H5NHCH3, and third is C6H5CH2NH2. So this is benzylamine. Now this nitrogen is not directly attached to this benzene ring. Therefore, there is no involvement of lone pair of nitrogen in resonance. So the basic strength is C6H5NH2 is the least basic than this, and the most basic is this benzylamine. Next is decreasing order of basic strength in gaseous phase. In gaseous phase, tertiary amines are the strongest base, then secondary, primary, and then ammonia. So here this is primary amine, this is secondary, tertiary, and ammonia. So the order is tertiary amine, secondary amine, then primary, and then ammonia. Next is, in increasing order of boiling points, C2H5OH, CH3 twice NH, and C2H5NH2. So here one is alcohol, secondary amine, and primary amine. So if we compare the boiling point of alcohol with amines, so alcohols has higher boiling points. And if we compare the boiling point of primary and secondary, the number of hydrogen atoms are more in case of primary amines. So the extent of hydrogen bonding is also more in case of primary amines. So this is the increasing order of boiling point: secondary amine, primary amine, and alcohol. Next is an increasing order of solubility in water. So here primary aromatic amine, that is C6H5NH2, secondary amine and primary aliphatic amine is given. So primary aromatic amines are not insoluble in water. So this is the least soluble, then secondary amine, and then primary amine. Now next is question number 14, third part. Why are aliphatic amines stronger bases than aromatic amines? So here is the structure of प्राइमरी एरोमेटिक अमीन्स द लोन पेयर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन द लोन पेयर प्रेजेंट ऑन द नाइट्रोजन इज इन्वॉल्व इन द कॉन्जुगेशन विद दिस बेंजीन रिंग एंड दीज आर द रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स देयरफॉर दिस लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज नॉट इजिली अवेलेबल फॉर द डोनेशन टू प्रोटोन एंड दिस इज द रीजन एरोमेटिक अमीन्स आर वीकर बेसिस एज कंपेयर टू एलिफेटिक अमीन्स. So this is all about homework solution of lecture number 3. Thank you. Please like and subscribe this channel.